$5,000 for a $2,500 piece, who they don't even want to pay $1,800 for. If they could get for $2,300, he gets a way to get out, grab it, and go. All right, where are we going now, Danny, from Seattle? Louisville, Kentucky. I can't remember my own writing here. Hello there.
Good evening, Bruce.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm doing wonderful. First, I want to preface by saying I'm calling you with my future daughter-in-law's permission.
Okay.
I haven't stuck my nose in where it doesn't belong. Well, maybe I have, but she's accepted it.
She's letting you stick it in, huh?
Yeah. My son and his fiance plan to get married about this time next year, just before Christmas, which is wonderful. They've been living together now for a year, which is their way of doing it.
I see you didn't endorse that.
Well, I didn't have any choice in the matter, so.
No, but nonetheless, the way you put it was their way of doing it.
Well, that's right. My son is self-employed, owns his own home. He and the bank are owning his own home. And this young woman, who's a real sweetie, has two children, both by separate husbands, previous husbands, obviously, and has incurred some substantial debt on legal fees from the divorce and student loans for college. She's got about three and a half years of college under her belt, no degree.
How old is this girl?
She's 26.
Okay. And your son is how old?
He's 26 as well.
Mm-hmm.
The circumstances of her debt, the bulk of it is $5,000 on legal fees for these two divorces, which seemed like a whopping amount to me. Be that as it may, I've seen the bill, so it's there. Whether it's justified or not, I don't know. And a total of almost $8,000 on the student loan. Mm-hmm. She is employed full-time, and obviously a full-time mom as well. Her employment yields about $13,000 a year.
That's all?
That's all, yeah. Yeah, $6 and some change per hour.
What
is she
doing? Okay.
And her problem is, quite frankly, Bruce, on the $5,000 she owes the attorney. She's been paying on this bill now for 3.5 years, and it's as big now as when she started. And we have written a letter to the attorney requesting total time and charges on the breakdown of both all fees.
Well, she's probably paying more interest than she is principal.
Oh, I'm sure. Sure.
And that's perfectly proper.
If the man did the work and
right.
And the other side of this coin, and it might be the lawyer's doing, it might not, but certainly not to her advantage, is that the first husband has skipped your home state and not paying a penny. Has nothing in his name, lives with his mother. Mm-hmm. The second husband lives in the general area of Lowe, the adjacent county over, does occasional jobs in the way of, has his own business of a yard service, but we all know what that is, a trailer behind his car and maybe cuts a lawn or two and pays virtually nothing. Mm-hmm. His mom and dad, however, do make a fairly honest effort to cover the kids' obligations, and
it's quite interesting.
Yeah, it's of course that's not their responsibility, and this woman, young woman, has a fairly good relationship with
the grandparents. Well, right, they're still their grandchild.
That's right. Oh, absolutely, absolutely. Question comes down to this, Bruce: with the $13,000 in debt, which is virtually insurmountable for this young woman to pay off at this time.
Mm-hmm.
What direction and what course of action would appear to be, at least from the facts as I've expressed them, an appropriate course to take?
Well, I don't think there's a whole lot of choices here. The $8,000 is not dischargeable by bankruptcy.
Mm-hmm.
You're aware of that?
No, was not.
Student loans are not dischargeable.
Okay. Well, she ought to become an MD, then she doesn't have to pay them.
Well, that's another problem. For the meantime, they're not dischargeable and she owes the money.
Yeah.
The only thing that she could discharge by bankruptcy is $5,000. In my opinion, that's not worth going bankrupt for. Now, we haven't talked about your son. How much is he earning?
I don't know his total earnings, Bruce. I would guess my gut. He's self-employed. I'd say somewhere mid-30s to mid-40s.
What's he have in the way of assets?
I won't call him substantial, but he
owns cash.
He's got stocks, $60,000 to $80,000.
Well, the answer is have him pay off her debts. She's gonna marry her.
Yep.
That's the answer.
Yep.
And you can, I'm sure that the attorney's bill could be negotiated.
Absolutely.
For cash.
And also, she has talked with the student loan group, and they said that it's two different loans. They said they can pull the one loan back in, put them under the same refinance at a lower rate. I don't know if that's...
Pay it off. Pay it off. If you're... Look, does he love this girl?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, the next question is, the next circumstance is, it's his opinion that after the marriage, he'd like to adopt the two children.
That's fine.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I think
that's
so.
That's very nice of him. Yeah, it's, you know, that's the way it should be.
Yeah.
But the fact is, if he's got the assets, be easier to negotiate with the attorney and pay off the student. The student loans are not going to negotiate.
Yeah.
The attorneys, he'll probably take $2,500 cash.
Yeah.
And pay them off and start their life without all this aggravation.
I think you're right. I think it's good to hear.
I do wish you well, my friend.
Thanks so much. Oh, by the way, Bruce, I've been chasing you around the Dow on the different venues in Louisville since about 2 years before your crash.
Boy, oh boy, that's a long time.
Well, I won't tell you that I'm the most loyal listener, but I've enjoyed every minute I've heard.
Well, I appreciate that. Thank you. You know, I was out again today flying around the Gulf of Mexico. I really enjoy that airplane again. It's the one place that I can be totally relaxed.
Well,
I mean, you fly in an airplane, you can be relaxed. You pay attention. But nobody bugs me, I guess, is what it comes down to. That, and I suppose, to a lesser degree, go out in the boat. But I have a boat in my backyard here, but I'm not real big on the boat thing. But I sure do enjoy that flying. I'm Bruce Williams.